स्टूडेंट इन प्रीवियस लेक्चर वी डिस्कस अबाउट द फिफ्थ लेसन दैट इज इनसाइड द एटम इन दिस लेसन वी विल डिस्कस अबाउट द डिफरेंट एटॉमिक थियोरीज इन दैट वी सी द डाल्टन्स एटॉमिक थियोरी सेकेंड Thomson's plum pudding model of atom and third theory we discussed that Rutherford's nuclear model of atom. So in this Rutherford's nuclear model of an atom we discuss about the points. So there is a positively charged nucleus at the center. Second point is almost the entire mass of the atom is concentrated at the nucleus. See here, and what we see, negatively charged particles called the electrons revolve around the nucleus, and the total negative charge on all electron is equal to the positive charge on the nucleus. See here, so because of that, atom is electrically neutral. And the last point is there is an empty space between the revolving electron and the atomic nucleus. So these are the points which are put forth by Rutherford. So today we are discuss about the next theory. So see students, an established law of physics, an electrically charged body is revolving in a circular orbit, its energy decreases. According to this law, the atom described in Rutherford's model turns out to be unstable. In reality, however, all atoms except radioactive atom are stable. This shortcoming of Rutherford's atomic model was removed by atomic model put forth by Niels Bohr in 1913. So students, we are going to discuss about the Niels Bohr stable orbit atomic model. So according to Niels Bohr, see here, this is the scientist Niels Bohr. So see here, in the year of 1913, Danish scientist Niels Bohr explained the stability of atom by putting forth stable orbit atomic model. The important postulates of Bohr atomic model are as follows. So students, see the what is the first postulate. So according to Niels Bohr, the electrons revolving around the new atomic nucleus lie in the concentric circular orbits at the certain distance from the nucleus. So students, here what is atomic nucleus lie in the concentric circular orbit. So what is concentric circular orbits? So in maths you studied concentric circles. So what is the concentric circle? So concentric circles means the circles having one nucleus or one center. The different circles having one center and radius of that circles are different, so that circles are called as concentric circles. So here we discuss about the orbits. So concentric circular orbits means their center is the nucleus of atom. So the concentric circular orbit, so center of that orbit is what? Nucleus of the atom. And there are, assuming the nucleus of atom is the center of circle, there are some circular orbits. So these are called as concentric circular orbits at a certain distance from the nucleus. Ashe hai circular orbits kashe ahet, nucleus pasun certain distance varti ahet ki jacha madhe electrons kay kartat, revolve kartat. So the second assumption of Niels Bohr is energy of an electron is constant while it is in a particular orbit. So This is the one of the important aspect of the Niels Bohr atomic theory. What is electron of an electron, energy of an electron, it's constant while it is in a particular orbit. So see here, what is the see here, so this is the nucleus of the, or this is the nucleus of atom. This orbit is first orbit, this orbit is second circular orbit, this orbit is third circular orbit. So these are the concentric circular orbit. So this is the first orbit, so this is called as N1, this is the second orbit, this is called as N2, and this is the third orbit. So what is the second? Energy of an electron, it's constant. So see here, in first orbit there are some electrons, so energy of electrons which are present in the first orbit and the energy of electrons which are present in the second orbit, the both the energies of electrons are different. See here, means what? The all electrons present in the orbit N1 having same energy, and all the electrons which are present in the N2 orbit having same energy. See here, this is the second assumption. What is the third assumption? See here, when an electron jumps from an inner orbit to an outer orbit, it absorbs energy equal to the difference of its energy level, and when it jumps from an outer orbit to inner orbit, it emits energy equal to the difference of its energy level. So see here, if electron have to jump from any orbit, so see here, if electron, see here, this is the blue colored arrow which shows the increasing energy of orbit. So energy of first orbit is smaller than energy of second orbit, energy of second orbit is smaller than energy of third orbit, means as the orbits are increases, energies are also increasing. So if electron have to jump from inner orbit to outer orbit, it absorbs the energy. How much energy he absorb? The difference between the these two orbits, that energy is absorbed by the electron. Or when it jumps from outer orbit to inner orbit, at that time it emits the energy, because the energy of outer orbit is more than energy of inner orbit, so it emits the energy. And how many energy it emits? It emits the energy equal to the difference of its energy level. So these are the main three assumptions regarding Bohr's stable orbit atomic model. So see here, according to the Bohr, this is the structure of atom. So this is the positively, see here, this is the positively charged nucleus, and this is the first orbit. That first orbit is called as K shell. This is second orbit, this second orbit is called as L shell. This third orbit is called as M shell, and this is the fourth orbit is called as N shell, and it is going so on. Fifth orbit, sixth orbit. So this is the Bohr stable atomic model. So see here, next, some more atomic models were put forth by Bohr's after Bohr's atomic model. Atomic structure was studied at the depth with the advent of a new branch of science called quantum mechanics. So student, what is by quantum mechanics? So quantum mechanics is the branch of mechanics that deals with the mathematical description of the motion and interaction of subatomic particles, etc. So it is the branch of science that is studied the atomic structure, that is called as quantum mechanics. So with all those, some well accepted fundamental principles of atomic structure are as follows. So see here, This is the atomic structure. So now we study in detail about how is atomic structure. So see here, atomic structure. An atom is formed from the nucleus and extranuclear part. These contain three types of subatomic particles. So atom is formed from which? Nucleus and extranuclear part. See here, atom is formed from the two components, that one is nucleus and another is extranuclear part. So see, student, next we see what is the nucleus. So nucleus is a positively charged, what is, student, you must have to remember, the charge on nucleus is positively charged. Almost entire mass of an atom is concentrated in the nucleus. See here, entire mass is concentrated in the nucleus. The nucleus contains two types of subatomic particles. These particles are called as nucleons. And student, which are those particles? Protons and nucleons. These are the two particles which are present or located in the nucleus. See here, all of you can understand what is nucleus. So nucleus is a positively charged particles. See here, so student, you must have to focus on the nucleus. So student, see here, next there is a one question. Why atomic mass of nucleus is concentrated at the nucleus? Because nucleus contains two particles, that is protons and electrons. Protons and neutrons. These two subatomic particles are situated in the nucleus. So the entire mass of nucleus is concentrated in the nucleus. I think all of you understand what is nucleus. So see here, students, this is the structure of nucleus. These are the positively charged atoms or the positively charged particles called as protons. The red color positively charged particles are protons and blue colored chargeless particles are neutrons. This blue color is chargeless particle and this is neutron. So next point is we are going to discuss is proton. So see here, student, proton is a positively charged subatomic particle in the atomic nucleus. Student, all of you remember that proton is positively charged atomic particle in the atomic nucleus. The positive charge on the nucleus is due to the proton in it. आता आपण काय बघितलं, nucleus is a positively charged. But why nucleus is positive charge? Because in nucleus there is a proton. So because of that proton, proton is positively charged. So nucleus is also a positively charged. See here, a proton is represented by the symbol which? P. The proton is denoted by the symbol P. Each proton carries a positive charge of electrons. So on proton, how much charge is present? 1.6 into 10 raised to minus 19 coulomb. Itka charge tya ekka proton varti present asto. When total positive charge on nucleus is expressed in the unit of electron, its magnitude is equal to the number of proton in the nucleus. हे किती असतात charges? एका जेवढे protons त्या nucleus मध्ये present आहेत तेवढे charges त्या nucleus वरती असतात. So the number of protons in the nucleus of an atom is the atomic number of that element and is denoted by Z, mass of the proton. See here, is approximately 1 dalton. किती आहे त्याचा मास? 1 dalton. So see here, the number of proton in the nucleus of an atom is the atomic number. So see here, atomic number means what? Number of protons. And that number of protons is denoted by the letter Z. See here, all of you understand, student, remember that atomic number is denoted by the letter Z. And what is atomic number? Atomic number means the number of protons or number of electrons which are present in the atom. See here, and the one proton is approximately 1 Dalton. I think all of you understand. So see the students, next part is neutron. So students, see here, neutron is electrically neutral. Kasa hai to? Neutron is electrically neutral because neutron does not having any charge. Neutral subatomic particle, and it is denoted by symbol N. Kaisani show karta to? Symbol N. And the number of neutron in the nucleus is denoted by symbol N. Number of neutron in the nucleus is denoted by the symbol N. Atomic nuclei of all elements except hydrogen with atomic masses 1 Dalton. This symbol, see student, this symbol is called as Dalton. Contains neutrons. The mass of neutron is approximately 1 Dalton, which is almost equal to the that of proton. So the mass of neutron is approximately equal to what? 1 neutron. See here, or 1 proton. So mass of proton is equal to the mass of neutrons. So see here student, next part we have discussed here, the extra nuclear part. So see here, in extra nuclear part in the atomic structure includes electrons revolving around the nucleus. So in extra nuclear parts, what involves in extra nuclear parts? Only electrons which are revolving around the nucleus. Electrons kute move hotat kiwa kute revolve hotat? Electrons revolving around the nucleus and the empty space in between the nucleus and the electron. So here is the extra nuclear parts. It contains electrons. So student, next we discuss about the electron. So student, see, electron, what is electron? So electron is a positive, electron is a negatively charged subatomic particle. Student, there are only 3 subatomic particles which are present in the nucleus. One is proton, that is positively charged. Second is neutron, that is chargeless. And third one is electron, which is negatively charged subatomic particle and is denoted by the symbol like this, E and negative. So that is this is also called as electron. Each electron carries 1 unit of negative charge. Kiti electron ka charge asto? 1 unit of negative charge. So mass of electron is 1800 times less than that of hydrogen atom. So therefore the mass of electron can be treated as negligible. So mass of electron is how much? It is very very small, so it is negligible. So electron in extra nuclear part revolve in the discrete orbits around the nucleus, the orbits being 3-dimensional in nature. A term shell is used to instead of orbit. Which word is used to orbit? Shell is used instead of the term orbit. The energy of electron is determined by the shell in which it is present. See here student, the number of electrons in the extra nuclear part is equal to the number of protons in the न्यूक्लियस. तो सी हियर स्टूडेंट्स, द नंबर ऑफ इलेक्ट्रॉन्स एंड द नंबर ऑफ प्रोटॉन्स आर इन इक्वल नंबर. सो हाउ मच इलेक्ट्रॉन्स आर प्रेजेंट इन द न्यू एटम, दैट मच प्रोटॉन्स आर प्रेजेंट इन दैट एटम ऑल्सो. सो देयरफॉर इलेक्ट्रिकल चार्जेस आर बैलेंस्ड एंड द एटम इज इलेक्ट्रिकली न्यूट्रल. सो स्टूडेंट्स सी हियर इलेक्ट्रॉन्स, सी हियर स्टूडेंट इलेक्ट्रॉन्स हैविंग निगेटिव चार्ज, प्रोटॉन्स हैविंग पॉजिटिव चार्ज. सो देयरफॉर नंबर ऑफ इलेक्ट्रॉन एंड नंबर ऑफ प्रोटॉन्स आर बैलेंस्ड, बिकॉज ऑफ दैट एटम इज इलेक्ट्रिकली न्यूट्रल. सी हियर स्टूडेंट, नाउ वी सी द नेक्स्ट पॉइंट. इन दैट पॉइंट देयर आर सम क्वेश्चंस ऑन पेज नंबर 32. सी हियर क्वेश्चन नंबर 1 इज हाउ मेनी टाइप्स ऑफ सब एटॉमिक पार्टिकल्स आर फाउंड इन एन एटम. हाउ मच पार्टिकल्स वी स्टडीड. नाउ देयर आर 3 पार्टिकल्स विच आर प्रेजेंट इन द एटम. सो विच आर दीज पार्टिकल्स, दीज पार्टिकल्स आर विच आर 3 पार्टिकल्स विच आर प्रोटॉन, न्यूट्रॉन एंड इलेक्ट्रॉन. सी हियर विच एंड द नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन इज विच सब एटॉमिक पार्टिकल्स आर इलेक्ट्रिकली चार्ज्ड. तो स्टूडेंट्स विच आर दी सब एटॉमिक पार्टिकल्स विच आर इलेक्ट्रिकली चार्ज, देयर आर 2 सब एटॉमिक पार्टिकल्स विच पार्टिकल्स हैविंग चार्जेस. सो फर्स्ट वन इज प्रोटॉन हैविंग पॉजिटिव चार्ज एंड सेकेंड वन इज इलेक्ट्रॉन हैविंग निगेटिव चार्ज. सो थर्ड क्वेश्चन इज विच सब एटॉमिक पार्टिकल आर प्रेजेंट इन द न्यूक्लियस, विच सब एटॉमिक पार्टिकल्स आर प्रेजेंट इन द न्यूक्लियस. सो देयर आर 2 सब एटॉमिक पार्टिकल्स विच आर प्रेजेंट इन द न्यूक्लियस. फर्स्ट वन इज प्रोटॉन एंड सेकेंड वन इज न्यूट्रॉन. वेयर आर इलेक्ट्रॉन्स रिवॉल्विंग अराउंड द न्यूक्लियस प्लेस्ड. सो बिहाइंड द न्यूक्लियस और अराउंड द न्यूक्लियस देयर आर सर्क्यूलर ऑर्बिट्स, कॉन्सेंट्रिक सर्क्यूलर ऑर्बिट्स और कॉन्सेंट्रिक सर्क्यूलर शेल्स आर देयर एंड इन दैट सेल्स इलेक्ट्रॉन्स आर रिवॉल्विंग कंटिन्यूअसली. सी हियर नाउ वी आर डिस्कस अबाउट द नेक्स्ट पॉइंट, मास ऑफ एन एटम, हाउ टू बी फाइंड आउट द मास. सो सी हियर द मास ऑफ इलेक्ट्रॉन इज बीइंग निग्लिजिबल, देयरफॉर द मास ऑफ एटम इज मेनली ड्यू टू द प्रोटॉन्स एंड न्यूट्रॉन्स. दिस इज द वेरी वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट पार्ट स्टूडेंट. सो मास ऑफ एन एटम इज मेनली ड्यू टू द प्रोटॉन्स एंड न्यूट्रॉन्स इन इट्स न्यूक्लियस. द टोटल नंबर ऑफ प्रोटॉन्स एंड न्यूट्रॉन्स इन एन एटॉमिक, इन एन एटम इज द एटॉमिक मास नंबर ऑफ दैट एलिमेंट. एंड द नेक्स्ट द मास नंबर इज डिनोटेड बाय द लेट सिंबॉल ए. मास नंबर कशाने डिनोट करतात, सिंबॉल ए नी. सी हियर इज डिनोटेड बाय सिंबॉल ए. द कन्व्हेन्शन टू डिनोट ॲटॉमिक सिंबॉल अँड ॲटॉमिक नंबर अँड मास नंबर आर टुगेदर इज शोन ॲज फॉलोज. टू स्टुडंट्स सी हियर, सो मास नंबर इज डिनोटेड बाय द लेटर ए. सी हियर अँड देअर इज अ कन्व्हेन्शन टू डिनोट द ॲटॉमिक सिंबॉल अँड ॲटॉमिक नंबर, ॲटॉमिक सिंबॉल, ॲटॉमिक नंबर अँड द ॲटॉमिक मास, मास नंबर टुगेदर धीस सिंबॉल, धीस इज ए झेड अँड धीस इज द सिंबॉल ऑफ इलेमेंट. सो फॉर कन्व्हेन्शनल वी राईट द सिंबॉल. सी हियर धीस इज द सिंबॉल ऑफ कार्बन. सो कार्बन, सी इज द सिंबॉल ऑफ कार्बन इलेमेंट, 6 इज द ॲटॉमिक नंबर. वॉट इज हियर, राईट हियर बिलो द सी, दॅट इज 6. वॉट इज 6? 6 इज झेड. सो वॉट इज झेड, झेड इज द ॲटॉमिक नंबर, मीन्स नंबर ऑफ प्रोटॉन्स, मीन्स कार्बन ॲटम हॅविंग 6 protons. And what is this 12? This 12 is the A. A means what? Atomic mass number. So atomic mass number is the addition of proton and neutron. So there is a 6 protons and 6 neutrons. So the atomic mass number of carbon is 6 plus 6, 12. I think student all of you understand. See here, that is the proton number of carbon is 6 and the mass number of carbon is 12. From this, it is also learned that the nucleus of carbon contain 12 minus 6, that is 6 neutrons. So see here student, next we see the question, the symbol of oxygen. So see here student, the symbol of oxygen is O. Therefore there are 8 protons and 8 neutrons in its nucleus. From this, determine the atomic number and mass number of oxygen and arrange these in a conventional symbol. So students, here what is the question? We see the question, the symbol of oxygen is O. There are, this is the symbol of oxygen, O. See here, there are 8 protons and 8 neutrons. So from this we have to determine the conventional symbol. So conventional symbol is written like this. Is we have to write A here and we have to write Z here. So from this we write, see here, this is the symbol of oxygen and how many protons are present in the oxygen? There are 8 protons. So we write here 8. And how much neutrons are there in oxygen? There are 8 neutrons in the oxygen. So atomic mass number of oxygen is 8 plus 8, 16. So we write here 16. So this is the conventional form of the, or conventional symbol for the oxygen. All of you understand, students? Understand. So see students, there are total 5 questions are there. So you must have to solve these questions at home. So next point of this lesson is distribution of electron. So this is the one of the most important part of this lesson, distribution of electron. So students, see, as per Bohr's atomic model, electrons revolve in stable shells. These shells have definite energy. The cell nearest to the nucleus is called as first cell and the next cell is called as second cell, and a symbol N is used for the ordinal shell. A symbol N is for the ordinal number of shell. The shells are referred to the by the symbols K, L, M, N. We see that corresponding to the ordinal number N equal to 1, 2, 3, 4 and so on. The maximum number of electron in a shell can contain is obtained by the formula 2N square. See here student, this is the formula to find out the maximum number which are present in the, or which contain electron in the shell. So as the magnitude of N increases, the energy of electron in the, in that shell increases. So see here, this is the table on page number 32. We have to complete this table by using the formula 2N square. So see here, symbol of cells are given K, L, M, N and so on. N is the number of shell, that is 1. Now we have to solve this. See here, L, so number of electrons is how much? 2 into square of 1 is 1. So 2 into 2. So in first orbit, there are number of electrons the capacity of the first shell is 2 electrons. Now L is the second shell, so here number of N is the 2. So see here, 2 into 2 square. So see here, 2 into what is square of 2, that is 4. 4 into 2, 8. What is 8? So the electron capacity of the second shell is 8 electrons. Now M is the symbol of the third shell, and now we are going to find out the electron capacity of the shell M by using the formula 2n square. 2 into n means 3 square. So square of 3 is 9, and 9 into 2 is 18. So the capacity of third shell is 18 electrons. So capacity of third shell is 18 electrons. Now N is the fourth shell. So N is 4. By using the formula 2N square, 2 into what is N? 4 square. So square of 4 is 16. And 16 into 2, that is 32. So there are total 32 electrons is the capacity of fourth shell of the atom. So according to these electrons, this is the electron capacity of the shell. So student, you have to find out the next KLMNOP, like that, QRS. So these are the electron capacity of the cell. So first cell there are only 2 electrons, in second cell there are only 8 electrons. So students, see here, next, this is the nucleus of atom, this is the first cell. So capacity of first cell is only 2 electrons. This is the second cell, capacity of second cell is 8 electrons. And this is the third cell, the capacity of third cell is up to 18 electrons. Means one first cell contains up to 2 electrons, second cell contains up to 8 electrons, third cell contains up to 18 electrons. So this is the distribution of electrons. So electrons. So students, today we are discuss about the Bohr's stable orbit atomic model. After that we studied the atomic structure. In atomic structure we studied the nucleus, protons, neutrons and electrons. And now we discuss the distribution of electrons. So students, all of you please complete the notes in your notebook. Understand? And if you have any doubt, any queries, please ask me. Thank you.